This lecture is part of the ARIA course I have on Udemy available for purchase. It is the highest rated course in the accessibility section on Udemy and it has 4.8 stars and over 100 students. Feel free to enroll and ask me any questions that you have. Thank you. What is ARIA? ARIA is a set of attributes that helps create more accessible websites, web applications, or even the more accessible SVGs. They are meant to supplement, usually, the HTML on top of which you build your site. Now, with ARIA, it is very important to get it right. So if you use ARIA, it is very important to know which attributes to use, their properties, their states, and to have correct values. There are a lot of ARIA roles, attributes, and states, but it is not necessary that you memorize all of them, or it is not necessary that you use all of them. In fact, if you use absolutely all of them on a website, it's probably you're doing something wrong. You have the rows, so you have widget rows, you have like button, checkbox, link. Basically, a lot of native HTML elements have started to replace ARIA. However, ARIA is still very much used when you're building dynamic UI, for example, a hamburger icon. So you have rows, composite rows, document structure rows. For example, if you have a heading or a group or a figure, you can also add ARIA landmark rows. You probably remember that the banner is actually the header, the content info is the footer, complementary is the aside. You know, those are the HTML5 elements we usually use, but they also act as an accessibility landmark. Live regions, this is where you have the a piece of text get announced to a screen reader. And then you have states and properties, which are a lot of them. And here we have the ARIA expanded, like we talked about earlier. It is not necessary that you use ARIA to create an accessible website. For example, if your website is really, really simple, this is the example domain website. It contains a heading, paragraph, and link. This website requires absolutely no ARIA because it is so simple. That means that the text doesn't require any ARIA, and just adding ARIA is going to be an overkill. Now, let me show you let me create some attributes so I can show you how that works. Okay, so let's create a basic button. So to create a button, you know, you use the HTML element called button. And let's say we have a close button. Now, close buttons usually have an X, okay? Now, the issue with X is that even though X is pretty obvious for sighted users, screen reader users might not know what X stands for. And that's why we are going to be using ARIA for this. Now, let's test this button with our screen reader to see how it works. I'm going to fire up my screen reader now. Okay, so I have focused my button now with my screen reader NVDA, and now I'm going to make the screen reader repeat back the button.
Button X. Button X.
Okay, this is not descriptive at all if you're using a screen reader. If you're sighted, you can see that the X button is probably going to close something, but not for a screen reader. Now, let's make it accessible for a screen reader. First, I'm going to close off my NVDA using Insert plus Q.
Exit NVDA dialog.
Okay, and now I'm going to use area label. So area attributes, they sometimes have the area prefix on them, or sometimes they don't. So you can have row, which is also an area attribute. It just doesn't have the area prefix. In this case, area label does have the area prefix. And as you can see, it is just a normal HTML attribute, so it's nothing special. So I'm going to say area label, and I'm going to say the value will be close window. So let's pretend that this button actually closes a window. Now let's fire up the screen reader again and see what it says.
Button close window.
Now this is much better, isn't it? We used ARIA to make this interface more accessible. So that's really, really good. Now, another thing you can also use ARIA for is if you have a dynamic dropdown, for example, those hamburger menus, you can use the ARIA expanded to announce to the users when something has expanded or collapsed. So ARIA is very much used building dynamic applications and dynamic UI, because when you have things moving onto the screen, if you're sighted, it's very easy for you to see them. But if the user is using a screen reader and they're visually impaired or are blind, then it's going to be much more difficult for them. Let's go to the WISE website where they have implemented a really good hamburger menu and see how they did it, how they used ARIA for that. So I'm going to have the screen reader. I have focused the menu with my screen reader and I'm going to have it announce it now.
Menu button collapse submenu menu.
Okay, notice how it says collapse. So I'm going to expand the menu now using spacebar.
Expanded submenu.
There we go. You can see that the menu is expanded, and since they used area, they are able to announce that to screen readers. Now let's look at the source code for this menu. And this is the button. And right now, if I collapse it, it has an area expanded to false. When I expand it, the area expanded goes to true, and that forces the screen reader to say expanded or collapsed. And that's very straightforward when it comes to ARIA. Of course, you should always use to try to have semantic HTML as possible, but that doesn't mean that every semantic HTML is accessible. So only after testing, you should be able to figure out which ARIA you need to use. So like I said, there are many different types of ARIA. I'm going to show you an example of the landmark areas. So if I'm going to test my screen reader on this page, it only has divs, so those divs have no semantic meaning.
Header, main, footer.
See, the screen reader announced header, main, and footer as if they have no semantic meaning whatsoever. If I try to jump through these, if I press insert plus F7, if I open the elements list and I press on landmarks, I cannot jump through any of these because they are not semantically announced. This is where we're going to use the area rows, landmarks. Let me silence my screen reader first using insert plus S.
S. Speech mode off.
Okay, so I'm going to use the area landmarks right now, and you do this by using the row attribute. Now, you don't have to use this for landmarks only. You can also use rows. You can also have row button, row link, row image. There are many of them, but this one is for landmarks. So I'm going to say row banner, which is the header. The main is going to have a row of main, and the footer is going to have a row of content info. Now let's test the screen reader again.
Main landmark main, content info landmark footer. Footer, main landmark main, banner landmark header.
See how much more in detail the screen reader goes. Now let me fire up the elements list.
Speech mode off.
I'm going to press insert and F7. There we go. Now our landmarks can detect which is the banner, main, and content info only because we use the correct area. Of course, it is not, if you're coding in HTML5, it is not necessary to use this. You can just use the footer element, the main element, and the header element. So, like I said, whenever possible, try to use semantic HTML elements. However, just because these elements are semantic doesn't mean that they are going to be available to assistive technology. So always make sure that you test with screen readers. This is a big pitfall I see with using ARIAs. A lot of people think that, oh, I'll just use ARIA or I'll just use semantic HTML and I'll have to test my website. You always have to test your website with assistive technology. ARIA is also heavily featured in the WCAG. There is a specific success criterion called label in name, and this is used to help speech recognition software work together with ARIA to recognize elements. So this one, success criterion 2.5.3, label and name, is specific for area labels. This success criterion also affects area labeled by attribute. So let me show you how we can make our website conform to this success criterion. I'm going to open up my brackets and let's code the link. And let's say that this link, let's give it a text of learn more. Now, let's say that this is a blog post and we have area label, and then let's say that the area label says, you know, pretty flowers. Now, this is going to violate the success criterion label in name because the visible label is different from the area label. And users using speech recognition software, if they say, click learn more, the speech recognition software is not going to be able to find it because the visual label and the area label are different. So that means that the visual label must persist inside the area label. So let's fix that. To fix that, just make sure that you add the visual label inside the area label. So for example, learn more about pretty flowers. And this way you conform to the success criterion. So it is very important that you learn how to do it. And this is a mistake I see in many websites, the area label and the visual label. Now they don't have to be 100% the same, because if they are 100% the same, there will be no need to use the area label, but the visual label must persist inside the area label. Now this is only for buttons, for links, for any element that needs an accessible name. You don't have to add it into every single element. Now I want to mention one other misconception people have about area is that It is only for low vision, or it is only used for users with screen readers, which is not true. Aria is used by speech recognition software, which is a software that allows you to operate a website by using your voice. So like we said earlier, you can say learn more, click or learn more, and the voice recognition software is going to click it. So this is the voice recognition software is used very much by sighted users. For example, if someone has severe tremors on their hands, they have Parkinson's disease, or they have recently broken their arms, which, you know, it makes it impossible for them to use a mouse to operate the site. Aria is also very much used by other assistive technologies, such as Braille terminals. They use screen readers, the Braille terminals do, in order to activate the dots on the terminal. So, and any other assistive technology in the future that emerges that has access to Aria label, excuse me, that has access to Aria, will be able to use it. So it's really very much misleading to say only blind, that Aria is only useful for blind and low vision users. Not to mention that a lot of people who use screen readers, they are not blind or low vision. People with autism, people with migraines that makes their head hurts a lot when they look at screens, people with dyslexia, they also use screen readers and they can be sighted at the same time. So don't subscribe to the idea that Aria is only absolutely just for blind users. It has a wide range of application. So in this course, I'm going to be going through a lot of these attributes. But since this course is for beginners, we're only going to be looking at the attributes that are most often used. We're not going to be looking at all of them because that will be a really long course, that's for sure. And we're going to try to find out which ones we can use, which ones are, you know, popular, and what kind of support they have. Now, Aria was invented in 2014, and it is not like valid with HTML4, even though it works with HTML4, just the validation software is not going to validate your site. But if you're using HTML5, it is absolutely covered by HTML5. And I'm going to also explain you some things. For example, Aria Controls is not supported by any screen reader except JAWS. And even with JAWS, it has very limited support. So I tend to just not use it, even though you see in a lot of examples, they say, oh, Aria Controls is like very good attribute. Like if no assistive technology ever uses it, why spend time, you know, using it and developing it, and, you know? So that's pretty much what Aria is. It is not, if there are any takeaways I want you to take from here, is that Aria is not a replacement for HTML. Aria and HTML usually marry and work together to create an accessible website. Aria is not limited to HTML, it can also be used in SVG. Aria is not just for blind and low vision users. It can be used by speech recognition software, screen readers, Braille terminals, or any other assistive technology in the future that comes up and, you know, can use Aria. And the other thing I want to say is that always test your website, because even if you use 100% valid Aria, if you made a mistake or if the assistive technology is not supporting it, there's no point in just using Aria. That's pretty much what it is. And we'll dive further into the course. Thank you for watching this video. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like this video. You can find links to my courses in the description of this video. Thank you.